How can we transpose data that's in multiple columns, but also has multiple headers like this one, which is more like a reporting type of layout, into a tabular dataset like this, so that it's easy for us to create a pivot table or do further analysis using formulas? Now, I made a previous video on this that shows you how to unpivot your data if you have a single header. This time, let's take a look at a more complex unpivot situation. We also want to do it in a dynamic way though, so that if we end up adding more columns to this, all we need to do is refresh the end report and everything will pull automatically through. Let's get to work. This video is a part of my Ultimate Excel Power Query course, which will take you from beginner to writing your own M functions. Link is in the description below. So here we have our customer names, we have article description, and we have a nice report about sales values by month, which are actually recorded as dates, and by scenario. What we want to do is to transform this report into a proper tabular dataset. In the end, we should just have a single column for customer, for article, so just like we have now, except that there shouldn't be any gaps in there. Then we have a separate column for scenario, followed by a separate column for month, and finally a single column for the sales values. But we have a few challenges to overcome. Our first challenge is that we also have totals in the middle of this report, and we need to exclude these from our end result. So the pattern is we have customer information, and then we have the total for that customer, and then all the way in the end, we have the grand total. Now, in addition to this, our second challenge is to somehow overcome the problem of multiple headers. If we just had a single header, things would be a lot simpler. We can use Power Query's Unpivot feature and get this done really fast. But somehow we need to deal with this multiple column headers. Our third challenge is to get this to be dynamic, so that if we add data for future months, so let's say for April, all we have to do is refresh our end report and we get everything pulled through in a proper format. So let's see how we can set this up with Power Query. The first thing we need to do is send this data to the Power Query editor, which means we can work either with named ranges or with Excel tables. Now, I prefer to work with tables whenever I can, but what I don't want to happen is to change the look of this report. I want this to look the same, which means that when you want to work with ranges that looked like merged cells, you shouldn't use merged cells, and I haven't used it in this report. Instead, what you need to do, if I press Control 1, I'll show it to you in the alignment options here, is that you need to use center across selection, because this has the same visual effect as a merged cell, but it's not a merged cell. So when you create a table out of this data set, it's not going to disrupt the look of your report. Because remember, merged cells aren't allowed in Excel tables. So if you create a table that includes merged cells, these will be demerged. Here, because I'm using center across selection, I'm not going to have a problem. So let's create a table out of this, but just so we can keep our eye on the bottom of the report as well, let's split our view. So go to the View tab and add a split. On the bottom side, I'm just going to scroll all the way down so we can keep our table in view, the top part and the bottom part. Now let's select everything, press Control A, everything is properly selected, and then press Control T to create a table out of this. Now I don't want my table to have headers because I don't want the actual and budget to be used as headers, so I'm going to uncheck that and then click on OK. And to go back to the original look of this table, let's start by removing the table style. Then let's remove the header row. So these headers were automatically created by Excel because I didn't have any headers there. So it just puts the default column 1, column 2, etc. But I'm going to remove that. No one needs to see that. As a third step, let's give this table a name. I'll call it TCustomer. Now that everything is set up, let's send this to Power Query, data, from table range, give the end report a name, I'll call it data proper. Okay, so Power Query went ahead, it promoted the headers, and it added a change type step. I don't need these steps, so let's reverse them. Okay, so now let's think about the steps that we need to do to get this into a proper format. Well, the first thing is that we have to identify the anchor columns, basically the columns that we want to keep as is. That's our customer name and the article description, except of course they shouldn't have any gaps in them. So first thing, after you identify the anchor columns, fill up any gaps that they might have. So I'm going to right mouse click here, fill, and fill down. Now at this point, I'm not ready to use the Unpivot feature on this dataset because I have multiple column headers here. If I didn't have actual and budget information, I could unpivot the months and I'd be done with this task. But because I have multiple column headers, I need to follow a different set of steps. What I have to do next is to combine my anchor columns into a single column. So again, it doesn't matter here how many anchor columns you have. It could be more than two, but you just need to follow the same steps. It also doesn't matter how many levels of column headers you have. The same steps will also apply to those situations. Okay, so after you identify the anchor columns and you fill in the gaps, you need to merge them to become a single column, and you're going to see why in a second. From the Transform tab, let's go and merge the columns. Pick a separator that doesn't exist inside your dataset so that you're not using in the descriptions here. So I'm not using a semicolon. I'm going to go with that. You can just leave the default name here. We're going to be updating the column header names in the end. So go with OK. Now that we have a single column here, we can transpose this dataset. So that's going to put this on top here. So from the Transform tab, select Transpose. Now we have our different scenarios in their own columns here, and our dates, which are our months, in a separate column as well. So next step is to fill in any gaps we have here. So let's right mouse click, fill, and fill down. Now because we've created a single column header out of our multiple columns, we can promote this row to become headers. So use first row as headers. Now Power Query went ahead and automatically applied a change type step, but I don't need that right now, so I'm just going to remove that. We're going to apply a change type step in the end. Okay, so now we have a separate column for scenario, this is a separate column for date, and this is where our data starts. So because we have a single column header now, we're ready to use Unpivot. So select the anchor columns, right mouse click, Unpivot other columns. Now things are starting to look good. Before we update the names here, let's split our attribute column to the original two columns that we had. So under Transform, Split Column by Delimiter, the delimiter is a semicolon, and OK. Now let's remove that change type step as well. Next, let's give these columns a name. First one is scenario. Then we have the dates. Next is customer. Then we have our article. And finally, we have sales value. Now, one thing we still need to do is to remove the totals from here. So anywhere we have the word total, we need to filter it out. Let's go and add a text filter for this. And filter for everything that does not end with the word total, and OK. Everything looks good. Let's update the data types for this. Scenario is text. For date, let's just keep the date portion. Text and text is good, and sales value is currency. OK, everything looks good. Let's send this to Excel, close and load. It's going to create a new table on a new sheet with our report looking like a proper tabular data set. We have actual information here followed by budget information. We can of course change the order of this if we want customer and article to be first, followed by scenario and date. I forgot to do that, So let's go ahead and do that right now. Let's select both customer and article and pull them to the front and update our report. Okay, so everything is set up here. One thing we need to do is to make sure that it works if we add data for April. So I have some April data here. First column is for actuals and second column is for budget. So let's test that. I'm just going to add a column here for actuals and let's go and copy and paste this in. So April is from P4 until P130. I'm going to cut it. So Control X, go to the table here and Control V. For budget, let's just expand our table area here and do the same for budget. So that's Q4 until Q130, Control X and Control V right here. Now I'm also going to remove the split. So go to view and remove that split. And now let's check if April shows up in our end report once we press refresh. So currently we have 596 rows. Let's right mouse click and refresh. We have new rows pull in here, which looks good. So if we jump all the way to the bottom, we have April data automatically included. Now it looks like we have some cells on our report side that aren't picked up by Power Query as null value cells. That's why they show up in our end result here. So let's go and check that out and see how we can fix it. Let's go back to the merge column step. Now, most of the cells that are empty are seen as null here. So when we unpivot this, we don't see these as empty cells. So these are not the ones that are causing us problems. The ones that are these cells here. Later, when I go and unpivot, those cells are going to show up here as empty cells, like we see here. So they're still not null value cells. But after I update the type, and I change the sales value column to a currency, then these empty cells become null cells. So to clean up my final report, what I can do is go and remove any null cells here and go with OK, send this back to Excel, and I get back a report that's a lot leaner. Okay, so that's it. Those are the steps you need to follow when you come across more complex unpivot situations. I hope you enjoyed our Power Query unpivot example. Now, in case you'd like to learn more about Power Query and learn how to use it like an expert right from the start, make sure you check out my complete course. Link to it is below. As always, don't forget to hit that thumbs up before you leave, subscribe if you haven't, and I'm going to see you in the next video.